Okay, so we got this beer here called Dead Elephant IPA. I checked the brewery's website, nothing about this beer on it. Some of you might be like, fuck rape beer and all that, but I gotta tell you, even rape beer has nothing about this beer. Not this past October, because I went home a different way from an Oktoberfest I was at with some people. And yeah, we did check out a different liquor store that I've been to before, but last year in 2010, we were at this one liquor store heading on the way home from an Oktoberfest I'd never been to before, and I'm saying I'd never been to that liquor store before. They had a bottle of beer for sale called Dead Elephant Ale with a whole different picture. Now I can find that on their brewery's website, and I can find that on Rate Beer. It says it's 6.8%, and it says that it's an IPA. But this comes in at 6.5%, so I'm not gonna tell you fuck all about the IBUs and I didn't even I might have read some reviews about it, but basically didn't because this might be because it's something possibly different. So Railway City Brewing Company, I've never had anything from you before. Update your fucking website and let us know anything about this can. Is it the same thing as the other one? Why the alcohol percentage different? Now there's a story here. This is a strong beer. Mine's 6.5%. It says 1861 to 1885, and you see an elephant, and it's called Dead Elephant. Must be talking about an elephant. I'm gonna read you something here, folks. Here's to Jumbo, world's largest elephant, friend and prized character of P.T. Barnum's traveling circus. It was 1885 here in St. Thomas where he met his early demise in a tragic railway accident that they'll be forever remembered in the annals of beer in Canadian history. In his honor, we've crafted this full-bodied ale. Live life large. He'd have wanted it that way. And for you to drink responsibly, handcrafted in St. Thomas, Ontario. Don't know anything about this brewery. I'm already a little drunk. A Jumbo legend with an unforgettable taste. Not the first beer of the night. Sometimes I only have one beer in a night. Usually probably do, but sometimes I have more. Let's see what this one's like. 6.5. Hopefully I have enough time on my card. I don't know what I smell of the can, so I'll just pour it. Well, we don't want to overflow. We don't fucking want to overflow. Tons of head, but this style of glass, I don't know the name of the glass, but it usually gives lots of head on beers. You see the coloring. I'm gonna put it to the light. Yep, that's the coloring. Smell wise of Dead Elephant IPA. Not a lot to it. It's a soft, light background citrus up front. I want to say soft pillow, but how the fuck does that explain a smell, you know? So I'm going to dive in, 6.5. Let's see what we get. It's hoppy. It's heavy. Got lots of hop bite and lots of hop heaviness. It comes into my mouth like a refreshing watery taste, not a terrible watery taste. But that goes quickly into this really heavy, hoppy, bitter beer. The hops make it really heavy and bitter. If I try and play that taste around in my mouth after swallowing the sip, you know, if I move my tongue around, I don't know. I almost want to say It almost brings on some citrus. And maybe something between brown sugar or cinnamon slightly. I don't know. It's just really heavy, really hoppy. But, mind you, I may or may not have had something really hoppy, heavy like that earlier before this beer. It's not a terrible beer. Like, there's nothing gross about it. But it's not my thing. Yeah, put it this way. I don't find anything disgusting about it, but way too heavy and hoppy for my liking, so that's why I'm leaving it at 2. It's not gross. It's just, if you're a Hop Bomb fan, you'll find this kick-ass. But I'm not a Hop Bomb fan, so I don't find it kick-ass. But I don't find anything gross about it, though. Woo! So, 2 out of 5. And rest in peace to Guar's guitarist and this elephant. Schoolyard. Have you seen me?